Want to speed up your data entry in Microsoft Excel and also make sure your data is accurate? I would encourage you to use a data validation list in Excel. This works on Excel for Windows, Excel for Mac, also now for Android and iOS. It is a great feature. Let's dive into it right now. I've got a list of employees and I need to put in their office or their location right here. You don't want to come in here and just start typing in their locations because somebody may misspell one of the cities. They may start abbreviating it. So we want to use a data validation list. I would encourage you to put your data validation list on a completely separate worksheet. I've already made a second worksheet at the bottom. I named it data validation list. That is not required. I have a list of office locations or cities. I clicked in cell A2, and I've already made it a table with Control T. I clicked on OK, and that gave me the table. And then I did a sort A to Z, so all the cities are in order alphabetically. Here's one example I'm going to show. If I pop down here to the bottom of this, if you notice, I have a lot of cities that start with the letter W. And then I even have a few that have W and the letter I. Pop back over here to data entry. If I just start typing in WI, nothing happens. So to make sure everything is accurate and to speed this up, I'm going to select my range. I'm going to go to the data tab and over in data tools, you want to create a data validation list. Select data validation and then click data validation again. Three tabs, you're on the settings tab. It says you can put in any value. We don't want that. We want to do a list. Your source is that table you put on another worksheet. So I'm going to go click on data validation list, and I'm going to just click on the word city. That put in the range. Click OK. I'm back over on my data entry sheet. If you notice, Office has a drop-down arrow when you click it. In the past, years ago, I used to have to scroll down here if I wanted to use the letter W. I can now just start typing it. I don't even have to click the drop down arrow. There is Wichita Falls. I'm going to select it with the mouse. The next one is just going to be Wichita. To use the keyboard, you arrow to the one you want and just press enter. If you type in something that does not exist, you get an error message. That is why this is such a great feature. If you want to add messages box to your data validation, you can just simply highlight it again. I could have done this from the very start. Back on data validation, input message. You could put a message in here that says type in the name of a city or select the city from the drop-down arrow. That would be the input message. You can also have an error alert. You know, use the drop-down or type. Don't randomly just type in cities that don't exist. You can have all those boxes in play here. One final note. It is really important that you make it a table for this reason. If I need to add or start removing locations, I'm going to go back to my data validation list. Because this is a table, if I go to A338 and I just type in a city, I'm just making up this with letters. And then I come and sort this. I will still sort it again just to prove that that is there. Sort A to Z, there's that city. Back over in my data entry, there it is right there. So make that a table and not a range for your data validation list. I appreciate your time. Feel free to subscribe to my channel. Also, my online training classes are available online. Of course they are. Have a great day. Thank you.